wherever he wants, white or black.
So again, you know, just started off the camp. You know, Edom came up with some questions, so we had to give him an answer. So first and foremost, all praise and honor and glory to Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai. Double honor to the apostles and the elders at Great Millstone for teaching the word of truth, sincerity, and for whom well. Salutations to my fellow Akron across the globe, preaching the same word of truth and sincerity in the name of Yahweh, the name of the Heavenly Father, the one of the world he calls God, his name is Yahweh, the name of the one of the world he calls Jesus, the so-called black man, okay? His name is Yahweh Shah, okay? And his people are people of color, okay? And his people also look like the people of the other nations, man. That's when you get confused in faith. Just like foreigners, okay? If your father goes back to the lineage of people on your side here, his forefathers go back to those people. Guess what? You're an Israelite according to the Bible, man. Okay? So that's the first and foremost thing. Now, the dude came up here last week. Last week, we were talking about the basics. That's something I want to kind of hold on to because, you know, you got a lot of young brothers, you coming in this shoot. You know, you got a lot of questions, man. And a lot of your questions can be answered through the scriptures, man. Well, all your questions can be answered through the scriptures. If you have proper understanding that the Lord is dealing with you, and then you can go to YouTube and you can type certain things like who is Esau, who is Jacob. Now we were going into that question with the guy that came here with his family. Okay, we're going into that question. Make sure this is recording.
Time.
We were going into that guy because you know a lot of these. If y'all can see what I'm seeing, man, y'all be saying the same thing, man. Y'all be saying the same thing, man. But anyway, long story short, people need to know who was Esau, who was Edom, okay? Well, Edom, you so-called white people, you Caucasians, okay? You come from the seed of Edom, who we call today the so-called white people. Now, not everybody that look like the so-called white man is an Edomite. You got our people scattered amongst the nation of Edom that actually are Israelites, but they look like Edomites. So the point of the matter is, you want to talk about who's Edom, where did the so-called white man come about? Well, he came out of Edom, which is Jacob, Israel, okay, his twin brother, man. His paternal twin brother. Meaning they didn't look alike. And what did they not look alike? They didn't look alike skin complexion, man. They weren't alike in the same spirit. So when you read scripture, Genesis, chapter 20, 25, verse 23, it says, Yahweh said unto her, two nations are in thy womb. So two nations were in Rebekah's womb. Even though they were twins, they were going to be two nations, two different nations. They weren't going to be the same. And spiritually, they weren't going to be the same. Physically, they weren't going to be the same. Aesthetically, all right? Even though they were related. It's like the brother, Priest Sabar, he goes in, brother from the maid camp, He speaks about it. He says, look, man, you know, a lot of people talk about separatism and this and separatism and that. But so-called Negro, so-called West Indian, Haitian, Latino, and Native American, we're more close in kinship to the so-called white men than any other nation, man. We're related. But the so-called white man, since he's had rulership over us, since he's had rule over us, he's been destroying us, man. He's been destroying his brother. He's been destroying his brotherly covenant, man. He called us by different names, Negro, African-American, color, Latino, Hispanic, Mexican, but he's just been slandering us, man. He's been slandering his own brother, man. But then when judgment comes down, then he want to remember, oh, we're brothers. We're all the same. But we're not. According to the scriptures, we're two different people. And the Lord said unto her, two nations are in thy womb. Two men of people shall be separated from thy bowels. And the one people shall be stronger than the other people. Now, when you look at the so-called white people, white man, so-called Caucasian, and when you look at the so-called Negro, Latino, and Native American, are we not stronger than the so-called white man? Yes, we are, in every way. Physically, mentally, spiritually, morally, right? There's a separate, okay, line drawn for us and them, man. All right? And it says, the one people shall be stronger than the other people, and the elder shall serve the younger. So it was said in the scriptures that the elder was going to serve the younger, man. Now let's see who came out first. And when her days were to be delivered, were fulfilled, behold, there were twins in the womb. And the first came out red all over, like a hairy garment, and they called his name Esau. So Esau was going to be the servant of his younger brother, Jacob. Now, what's this? Is the so-called white man serving the so-called black man? No, not yet. Why? Because the earth was given into his hands. When you read Job 9 and 24, it tells you what? It says the earth is given to the hands of the wicked. He covered the faces of the judges thereof, if not him. Where and who is he, man? And the chief judge that Esau covered over was the heavenly father and his son. Okay? In the 14th century, the late 14th century would be the late 1300, the so-called white man came up with the right idea to pay himself as the living, as God. And if there is a God, he had to look like him. And so this is the picture that many millions of Israelites all over the world, they venerate, man. And not only the Israelites, but you got millions of these heathens. They venerate a so-called recognized or iconicized image of the one they call Jesus and the one they call God. So if we were looking for the wicked, we don't have to look too far. It's the so-called white man. Okay? Now. Yeah, and the so-called white man, he's about to serve his brother, man, Jacob, which is the nation of Israel, man. Okay? He's going to serve us, man. Because right now we've been under his thumb. We've been under his foot for the last 500 plus years, man. Okay? It's a lot. Making sure the camera working. God, we've been under his rulership, his rule for the last 500 plus years. And now, so-called white man, so-called white woman, so-called white child, they're going to be our slaves. Like that woman you just saw walk by, she's going to be a concubine, man. A sex slave in the kingdom of heaven, man. Right along with the rest of these heathen nations, man. Okay? Well, I don't know if y'all seen it, but anyway, so the scriptures goes in to give a description of Esau, what kind of person he is. And when you look at the kind of person Esau was and is, you know that, oh, that's a so-called white man. When he's born, he's beat red, man. Okay, now they say all babies come out colors, but that's not true, man. When a so-called white man is born, he comes out red all over, like a hairy garment, man. And that, when Israelites are born, man, they come out, you know, white, they come out brown skin, all the white, man. All right? Reading on, verse 26. And after death came his brother out, and his hands rolled up with Esau's heel. And his name was called Jacob, and Isaac was 34 years old when she bore him. So Jacob handheld Esau's heel. Why is that? Because it was going to be symbolic that Jacob was going to bring down his brother Esau. That's why when you read 2 Exodus, chapter 6, verse 9, Exodus 6 and 9. It says, for Esau is the end of the world. I'm sorry, verse 6 and 8. I'll start at 7. 2 Exodus 6 and 7. Then answered I and said, what shall be the parting asunder of time? Or when shall be the end of the first and the beginning of it that followeth? Because right now you see Esau's kingdom is falling apart, man. It's been falling apart since 1969, but now his society is falling apart. And a lot of these other nations, they're in cahoots. They want to know who's going to rule next after the so-called white man is destroyed, man. So you got Russian Edomites, they think they're going to be next. You got so-called Chinese, they think they're going to be next. The Arabs, the Africans, the Hamites, they think they're going to be next. But in truth and reality, the people that's going to rule this world and this world next, okay, is the Israelites, man. Jacob, okay? So it says, and he said unto me, from Abraham unto Isaac, when Jacob and Esau were born of him, Jacob handheld fast Esau's heel. Reading on. So Esau is the end of the world, so Esau, Edomites, they will be ruling at the end of this age, at the end of this world. Now, the question is, who rules the earth today? Who's in chief rulership? The so-called white man. He's the one in rulership. He's the one that rules the elite banking families. He's the one that run the banking cartels, your entertainment, okay? He's the one that's the head of the group. People such as the Rothschild. Okay? These people, these are the ones that's in power right now, in cahoots. These are the ones the Heavenly Father set up to rule this world in the end before he sends his son back, and he's going to establish the kingdom of heaven, which is the kingdom of Israel on earth. Okay? So, who rules the world? The Edomites. They're the ones in. So guess what? That's how we know that prophecy is true. We know that because right now, the time before the Heavenly Father comes to destroy this present world you call here today. The earth is still going to be here. The heavens are still going to be intact. But this rulership, this earth, is going to be destroyed. This Edomite rulership, okay? This heathen heaven moment is going to be destroyed, okay? Let Aqua out there watch these videos. I hope you're following along. Okay? Edom will be ruling in the end. But who's going to be ruling after Esau? 2 Kings 6:9. For Esau is the end of the world, and Jacob is the beginning of it that follows. Who is Jacob? The 12 tribes of Israel, man. The Israelites, the so-called Negro, Latino, Native American, the Seminole Indian. You're the Israelite Mexican. You're the Israelites the Bible speaks of. You're Jacob. We're going to be ruling in this upcoming world, man. When the so-called white man goes down, it's not going to be an Arab, a Chinese, or any of these other nations. It's going to be the children of Israel. The same people they call niggas, spicks, Negro, African-American, colored, wetback, Indian, savage. We're going to be ruling, man. Okay? Verse 10. The hand of the man is betwixt the hand of man is betwixt the hill and the hand of the question Everest asked thou not. Why? Because he already knew it was going to be children of Israel. The Heavenly Father Yahweh was going to use the children of Israel to bring down the children of Edom, which you call the so-called white man today. Right now we live in a world of so-called white supremacy. I call it Edomite supremacy, man. Okay? Everything is geared for Esau. If you're born looking like a so-called Edomite, a so-called white man, which is an Edomite, in this world, you're born with privilege, man. You, even if you don't understand it, even if you don't know it. Why? Because your forefathers are holding this privilege. No video, baby. See, Esau, this is an Edomite right here, man. Stop videotaping. Gaming? That's an Edomite for you, man. They can do whatever they want in this world. Why? Because they're in power. Okay? They are born with a so-called silver spoon in their mouth. Why? Because their forefathers are leading this charge, man. Who put the so-called Negro in the worst form of slavery ever known to man? Well, it was the Heavenly Father, but he used the so-called white men to do it, man. And then their recourse or their response to this is, well, blacks sold blacks into slavery. As if that's a get out of jail free card. No. You're the one ruling, man. And you're about to get taken out of your rulership by your Heavenly Father, Yahweh Shah. And he's going to use the children of Israel to do so. This is Ezekiel 25:14. And I will lay my vengeance upon Edom by the hand of my people, Israel. Is that happening? Those people that's in Israel today calling themselves the Jewish people, Israeli, are they taking out Edom? According to them, Edom has been done away with. According to them, all these ancient civilizations, such as the Edomites, okay, such as the Ishmaelites, the Moabites, the Ammonites, they tell you what, they're no longer here. But they don't show you any proof. These people aren't destroyed. These people are here today. They're calling themselves under other names, such as the Edomites. They're calling themselves Caucasian, white, American, English, Dutch, German. Okay? But these are the Edomites, man. And these are the people that's going along with it. So the Heavenly Father said he's going to lay his business upon Edom by the hand of his people, Israel. Let's read that again.